Welcome to this .NET MAUI combo box control tutorial. In this video, I will demonstrate how to display text in the input field, personalize the drop-down and clear icon, position the drop-down menu above the input field, and customize the items in the drop-down menu. First, I open an existing MAUI application. Here, I have already configured the .NET MAUI combo box control and bound the social media items to the item source property. To learn how to add .NET MAUI combo box into your MAUI application, watch the video link to the YouTube card above or in the description below. Now I run the application. You can see the list of provided items displayed in the combo box. This is the default color of the placeholder. To customize it, use the placeholder color property. Now, the text color in the input field has been updated. As you can see, this is the default color of the clear button. You can customize its color by setting your preferred color to the clear button icon color property. Once I select an item from the list, you'll see the clear button in the given color. Next, I'll demonstrate how to customize the colors for the combo box border and drop-down icon. To achieve this, I set the desired color to the drop-down icon color and stroke properties. The colors of the combo box border and drop-down icon have been updated accordingly. Now let me show you how to edit the selected item and customize the highlight color of the selected text. First, I'll enable the isEditable property to modify any text in the input field. After that, choose the desired color for selection text highlight color. Once done, the selected text will be highlighted when an item is picked from the list. Next, I'll show you how to display custom view in the combo box. To begin with, I define custom view with label control and set the text to be displayed in the input field. Then I apply a color to the text and center it using horizontal options and vertical text alignment. Now I run the application. You'll see the custom view appear in the combo box. Here, the list of items displayed in the drop-down box with the default height. You can change the height by setting an appropriate value to the max drop-down height property. Before running the application, I remove the code snippets related to the previous customizations. When I click the drop-down icon, you can see that a specific number of items is displayed based on the height. You can view the remaining items by scrolling through the drop-down box. Next, I'll show you how to customize the drop-down menu. You can customize the text color background and selected items background by specifying your preferred color. Further, I would like to add border thickness for the pop-up. So I set a color to the drop-down stroke property and define a value for the stroke thickness. Before running the application, I remove the code snippets related to the previous customizations. After loading, I will select an item by clicking the drop-down menu. You can notice that the customization has been applied successfully. By default, the drop-down menu appears at the bottom of the input field. However, you can change its position to the top of the input field by adjusting the drop-down placement property to top. Look, now the drop-down box is displayed at the top of the input field. As you can see, the drop-down menu appears only when tapping on the drop-down icon. To make the drop-down menu display whenever you focus on the input field, enable the Show Suggestions on Focus property. When I focus on the input field, the list of items is displayed. Finally, I'll demonstrate how to customize the items in the drop-down menu. Before proceeding, remove the code snippets related to the previous customizations. Next, I navigate to the Mono class. Here, let me define properties for the employee's profile picture, designation, and unique ID. In the View model, I replace the existing data with the employee's details. Then, move to the Main Page XAML. First, I modify the item source property. After that, set the text that appears when no employee is selected in the placeholder property. To enhance the appearance of the combo box, I'll need to use a custom template to showcase each employee's profile picture and designation in the drop-down list. To achieve this, I will begin by defining an item template followed by a data template. Then, within the View cell, let me create a grid layout, specifying values for margin, column definitions, and centering it using horizontal and vertical options. Next, add an image control, positioning it at the center with horizontal and vertical alignment options. Then bind the image source to the profile picture property. These images are already stored in the resources folder. After that, create a stack layout with specified values for margin and alignment options. Within this layout, I define a label control to display the employee's name, and another label for the employee's designation. Now I run the application. When I click on the drop-down icon, you can see the list of employees updated along with the customization. Let's wrap up this video. You learned how to display messages in the input field. You've also learned how to personalize the drop-down and clear icon, position the drop-down menu above the input field, and customize the items in the drop-down menu. If you want to see this example's work in code, download it from the GitHub link in the description below. I have also included a link where you can check if you qualify for our community license, which gives you a free license key for our entire .NET MAUI controls. If you found this video helpful, click the like button and subscribe to our channel to watch more videos like this. Thanks for watching.